to Let's Talk About It. I'm your hostess, Paulette Henson. Today is Saturday, November 21st, 2020. Welcome to the show. Today we have an exciting lineup of topics to talk about, but before I get into our mix, I'd like to dedicate this segment to McFadden and Whitehead, and it's called Ain't No Stopping Us Now. Please understand I don't own the rights to this music, but I'd like to humbly dedicate this segment to a group from back in the day. So with that, I welcome you to the show. Welcome to all my new viewers, and welcome to all my continued viewers that support me along the way. So, moving right along, our topics for today. Gosh, what has happened this past week? We are still going through an election process that should have been over, but we're getting a lot of pushback from this current president. We're also going to talk about just the voting and how it was disenfranchised among African Americans in certain states. We're also going to recognize our healthcare workers as well as our teachers, whom I'm sure a lot of you can appreciate all the work that teachers were doing prior to the pandemic. And lastly, we are going to talk about Thanksgiving and getting together, how we're going to just enjoy a different way of Thanksgiving this year by social distancing, possibly by Zoom calls, etc. So with that, stay tuned, and we will be right back to talk about just, gosh, so many things. Hello, we are back, and we are going to talk about what's been going on this week with the current president, who is just not recognizing that he lost the election. And so what he's doing is creating all of this havoc amongst the states where he thinks that it's questionable. He's even had people to actually try to throw out votes, actually African American votes in certain states. And so it's really causing a problem for Joe Biden in order to move forward and execute plans in order to tackle this pandemic, plans in order to hire the staff to run the country. And it just kind of sets them back, and it makes you wonder what kind of person would want to literally destroy the country that they want to continue ruling, but because they lost the election, now they just want to cause mayhem. And so that's what we are experiencing, what we're watching. We are in the middle of watching our country divide. And if you look on the map, even on the voting map, where you have the red states and the blue states, and it's just almost like divided down the middle. And so in those states, those are the states in where this president is caught, is inciting lawsuits and trying to delegitimize black votes. And so what does it say to you as a black person when you comply with the rules and everything of this country, and you submit a ballot to vote, and only to hear that your vote could have possibly been discarded or thrown in the trash just because the running president was not happy with the outcome. So it's something to think about. It's something to really be seriously thinking about moving forward, that we have to understand, do research on the people that we place in office. Everyone is not worthy to be a leader. And once that leader has displayed leadership that is inappropriate, they must be removed. And so with that, we're going to move on to our next topic, because of course that subject can just go on forever. So next up, we are going to talk about our healthcare workers and teachers. Okay, so we'll be right back. Stay tuned. Let's talk about it. Okay, so we are back, and I'd like to dedicate this segment to the OJs, and it's called Darling, Darling Baby. And in this segment, I wanted to just talk about the hard work that the nurses and the healthcare workers are doing. And they are overwhelmed. And for those of you that don't believe in this pandemic, you can talk to any healthcare worker and they will tell you that this is real. You know, these people are going through PTSD or TSD because the trauma is still going on. And they're exhausted because people aren't wearing masks and people aren't taking this seriously. So I do want to make a mention to all those that are healthcare workers, essential workers, teachers especially, that, you know, if it weren't for you and your dedication and commitment to your jobs, we would be lost. We wouldn't know what to do. So I commend you on your determination to stay in the fight and to continue to try to help people. And I hope that people will take this seriously and they will wear masks and they will wash their hands so that we can help these people to get a handle on this virus, help them to help the people that are in the hospitals now so that they can get those people well, so that they can help the other people that have issues outside of COVID-19. So I want you to know that you are recognized. We understand that you are tired, but you continue to do the hard work that is required. And not only that, putting your lives at risk, putting your family's lives at risk. And so it's just commendable, commendable to all of you. I also want to make a mention to teachers as well, because I stepped in there when schools were closed, and although you had so many challenges, you did what was necessary to teach our kids and our grandkids to make sure that their education continued. And so we want to recognize you and wish you all a happy holiday season, and just stay blessed, stay in the fight. With that, moving right along to our last topic, and that is Thanksgiving and moving forward with our business. What are you doing? You know, know, have you branded your business? You know, have you written down some ideas? What's going on? So let's talk about it. We'll be right back. Okay, so we are back, and before I get into this segment, I don't own the rights to this music, but this is the OJ's, and this is Living for the Weekend. We are going to talk about this week's Thanksgiving, and then we have Black Friday, and so this Thanksgiving is going to be totally different than any Thanksgiving we've ever experienced, right? We are not supposed to gather in, you know, big groups because of spread of the virus. And it's really getting scary because the virus is surging as we speak. And so the issue is that we don't know where each family member has been or who they've been in contact with or if they've contracted the virus. And we definitely don't want them to bring the virus home to any elderly or anybody like that. So we are doing things a lot differently. So I challenge you to send me your Thanksgiving ideas and your plans as to what you're doing. We are actually going to have a small dinner, and we're going to communicate via Zoom with our family members, and just to be safe. And that's really what it's about. It's about safety. Safety for you, your family, your parents, your grandparents, everybody. We want everybody to be alive, you know, after the holidays. So with that, moving right along, it's Black Friday, right? So now we're on the shopping thing. So have you guys gotten your Christmas shopping done yet? What's up with that? Like, for me, I've been slowly trying to do little shopping before the mad rush, but at the same time, there's like all of these great, great deals that only happen on Black Friday. So one of the things that I won't be doing is I won't be doing Black Friday shopping at the stores. I will not be doing that. So with that, send me your ideas. What do you guys have plans for Black Friday? What are you doing? Shopping online, that type of thing. Also in this segment, I wanted to talk about business because some businesses are closing, and as they're saying, some businesses are closing for good. So if your business is closing for good and you're at a crossroads and you don't know what to do or what career to take, you know, reach out to me via my inbox and I can help you to strategize on business options, specifically in insurance. Insurance business is booming. People need insurance in so many ways. Now with this pandemic, they need supplemental insurance to pay for those expenses when they're not able to work. And so those are ways that you can make money, you can get paid weekly, and it could be very, very lucrative. So with that, I want to wish everyone a very happy Thanksgiving. Enjoy your people, your family. Please social distance if you are getting together. Wear your mask, you know, have your hand sanitizers. Just take all of those safety measures that you need to take in order to stay safe. Okay, so with that, I am going to close off and all of my family members and friends celebrating birthdays and anniversaries. I've seen a lot of birthdays and anniversaries this month. I wish you happy birthday, happy anniversary. And just celebrating life. Enjoy. Enjoy each and every day. Appreciate each other. So with that, I am going to sign off. You guys have a wonderful week. And we will be back next Saturday. And we'll talk about it again. Okay? Bye-bye.